Welcome to Peak to Profit, where each week we share practical and tactical guidance to help you lead a profitable business. I'm Jennifer Drago, award-winning strategist and business coach. I help businesses develop a laser-focused strategy and roadmap for business growth so that they can earn more, work fewer hours, and amplify their impact. Today we're going to talk about serving as the CEO of your small business. Are you acting as a CEO or are you acting as an employee? If you're a leader in a business that you don't own, I would ask you a similar question. Are you honoring your leadership role and taking time to focus on strategic work that will move your business forward? Or are you at the beck and call of others, their schedules, and their needs? I remember working as an executive and feeling like I had no control of my own schedule. I couldn't make the difference that I needed to in that role until I carved out time in my schedule for strategic work that moved the business forward. Here are some telltale signs that you are acting more like an employee than a leader in your business. Employees generally don't delegate, they don't spend time planning ahead, setting goals, or analyzing business metrics. They go through their days and weeks without a real structured plan or a list of priorities, and they may not be evolving their services because they're too busy wearing all the hats. They also usually do not undertake business building activities like prospecting, selling, marketing, and networking on a regular basis. When you step into your CEO role or your chief executive officer role of your business, a mindset shift occurs. A CEO, in contrast, is going to spend time visioning and planning ahead. A CEO is going to set goals for their business, and they're going to adjust those goals quarterly to keep moving in the right direction of their roadmap. They're going to analyze their business weekly by viewing their dashboards and their financials. A CEO will take action each week, and they will set aside intentional time to do so in order to build their business through networking, creating leads, prospecting for clients, and putting themselves out there in various forms, including social media. They're going to spend time doing deep work, which may be creating content or services that will serve their clients. A CEO will also delegate work that's outside of his or her zone of genius. Early on in the business, this may not be financially feasible to delegate to someone else, but as soon as a CEO builds their path to profitability, they can start delegating work that keeps them in their zone of genius. So let's talk about how you can step into your CEO role if you're currently acting more like an employee in your organization. The first step is to have a vision. One of the most important roles of a leader is to have a vision of where they're taking their business. Take some time to craft a descriptive and inspiring vision for your company. I like to use a vision narrative, which is a series of 6 to 10 statements that, when read together, create a descriptive mental portrait of your business 3 years from now. You can use our free step-by-step workbook to craft one of your very own for your business. Download it at peaktoprofit.com/F/vision. Once you have this vision, you should keep it visible and read it at least weekly, if not daily. I recommend daily. You should also share it with your employees and contractors so they know exactly where you're taking the business and they can work toward that same vision. And don't just communicate it once and then keep it to yourself. Talk about it at every meeting and in every discussion that you have. Help others see how they contribute to making that vision a reality. The next thing you can do to step into your CEO role is to be sure that you have goals for your business. So if you don't have goals right now, I need you to set some. As a CEO, you should have a roadmap of your business that shows how you're going to work toward that vision narrative or that destination of where you want your business to be in 3 years. Generally, I recommend that you set goals at the beginning of your business's fiscal year and then review and adjust them quarterly. But if you don't have goals right now as you're listening to this, you need to set them for whatever the remainder of your business's fiscal year is. There is never a wrong time to set goals, except not setting goals. That's the only wrong thing that you can do. Don't wait until the beginning of a calendar or the beginning of a fiscal year. Just do it now. and then start again at the beginning of your next fiscal year. The next thing you can do to step into your CEO role is to keep score. After you create your goals, you want to develop a activities-based scorecard that tracks your progress on these goals. I call this your strategic scorecard. I also like to have an operational scorecard that tracks audience, reach, sales, conversions, revenue metrics, whatever metrics are important in your business. The operational scorecard needs to track both lag measures that lag the effort to required to create them, as well as lead measures. So, for example, my scorecard includes how many social media posts I do, how many videos I do, how many lives I do, how many podcast hosts did I contact, how many articles did I write. Those are lead-based measures. Those are activities that I can take that are going to pay a future dividend in my business. My lag measures are going to be my audience reach, my number of subscribers, the number of people that I'm connected to, as well as my sales and revenues. So make sure that your scorecard, your operational scorecard, has both lead and lag measures on them, but especially those lead measures. Those are the ones we sometimes miss. The next thing we can do to step into our CEO role is to plan weekly CEO time. To truly be a CEO and not an operational employee running around with your proverbial hair on fire, you need to control your weekly schedule in a few ways. First, at the beginning of your week, typically on a Sunday or on a Monday morning, you want to plan your week ahead according to your goals and priorities. You need to slot in all of your client and personal appointments and other non-negotiables. But then next, you plan your CEO time, which is typically a large block of time or two large blocks of times totaling about 4 to 8 hours per week. This is the time that you'll use to update your dashboards, analyze those metrics, set up systems that help you ultimately streamline your business, and to work on those business building tasks, which include those tasks that help you expand your network, your audience, your leads, and your clients. These tasks may include using emails or direct messages to reach out to nourish and create relationships. They may include coffee chats to understand a colleague's business and how the two of you can work together to support each other's business and share clients. Personally, I like to have Monday mornings and Friday afternoons as my CEO time. That's my preference, but you can plan whatever time during your week that works best. Ideally, you want to use the same consistent day and time each week, but I know successful business owners that vary it week to week based on what's going on in their lives and their family's lives. But after you plan your CEO time, guard it with your life. It is so easy to let other things slip into this nice, big, uninterrupted block of time. You'll be tempted, but stay true to the original intent of the time. Plan, create, and build your business. In your weekly planning, you also want to set aside time to accomplish your weekly big three priorities. Now, if weekly planning isn't something that you've tried, I have a free weekly planner that can help you to organize and prioritize your week like a CEO. You can download it on my website at peaktoprofit.com/F/weekly. The next thing that you can do to step into your CEO role is to be sure that you stay in your zone of genius. So it's easy as a business owner, especially when the revenues aren't rolling in the early part of our business, we do everything. We wear all the hats and it's a great way to control our expenses early on. But when revenue does start coming in, you want to consider what is in your zone of genius and what tasks are better done by others. Some people are great at everything. They can edit videos, they understand social media, they're great at marketing, they're not afraid of public speaking, and they can create all the content that is ever needed in the world. But as a CEO, you need to analyze what tasks are a great use of your time and what tasks could be better delegated to others. Perhaps your genius is creating content, and then you outsource the social media posting and the video editing to others, for example. And one final thought as you step into your CEO role, I want you to remember the Pareto principle. The Pareto principle is widely touted in business and life, and it states that 80% of your output will come from 20% of your input. Said another way, 20% of the things on your to-do list each week will result in 80% of your business results. So you need to be so focused during your CEO time on that 20%. And I'm guessing it's probably those business building activities that we spoke of before. Today's action takeaway for you is to audit your calendar and determine how you can step into your CEO role and stay in your zone of genius instead of acting like as an employee of your business. At a minimum, you can craft your vision and set your goals, and then set aside 4 to 8 hours of non-negotiable time every week to update your scorecards and to work on those business building activities such as marketing, networking, meeting sales prospects, and developing new products and services to serve your customer. As a business strategist, my job is helping you get clearer on yours, including your business vision and strategy. If you need help or just have questions, schedule a free strategy session today on my website at peaktoprofit.com. I hope you've enjoyed this discussion about how to lead your business in true CEO fashion. I'll see you next week. Bye for now.